Let us first acknowledge the presence of His Excellency, Associate Justice of the Supreme Court, Apo Lucas Bersamin, and the beloved lady, and family. Second, we would like to congratulate all the re-elected leaders of the province headed by our Governor, Eustaquio Bersamin, and family, Madam Ruby and family Mary. And we welcome and we pray with all wishes that newly elected officials of the province, headed by our Vice Governor, Madam Rosario Bersamin. And to all the stakeholders of this recent election, I have to salute all the apprentices. We are on the record that I think it was the first time that we are not put under communal control, and also the first ever, the most peaceful election held in APRA political history. Congratulations to all the apprentices, all the stakeholders, the strong leadership of the COMELEC, all the joint effort of the PNP and the Army. Here with us is General Suryano and Colonel Lusad. It's General Eriberry here with us. All the efforts of the peace conveners, the different citizens who volunteer themselves for a peaceful election. Nandiyan ko yung mga Dumfrel, Bumpis, and the PPCRB, and all the different volunteers so that to preserve the camp, a clean, honest, and authentic, meaningful, peaceful election. So to all my brothers and sisters, agyaman tayo na po Diyos, tanadano tayo na ito yung aldaw nga ag-celebrar and inaguraran natin dahil to a third termer nga ako gobernador, ako gobernador na kin, ken ni ako vice governor, ken namin nag-disangko ni ang panlalawigan members. May we also give a big hand all the SB members who are ating all of them are here, especially with the newly elected ones. On this occasion, three things that the Bishop would like to share with you based on this 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time readings. The first is public leadership is always, in faith, we believe, a gift from God. It's a gift from God. Second, public leadership is a vocation. It's a call to follow Jesus, who came not to be served but to serve. So it is more a living out of our Christian faith. And lastly, that the fruit of this servant leadership is to transform society. So not only we elected leaders, that they become the servant of the province, that they will, we pray and hope, that they will become transformative leaders of our province. So to the first, kunatayo ako, without God, we are nothing. No, awan ni ako Dios, awanti kong daway tayo nga tumaray kaya may botos nga agserbi iti probinsya tayo nga ama. Iso nga agyaman na una nga the organizers will first have a mass na daytoy na santuan na misa kaya panangdayaw kaya lalaro ako asla ipanegneg tayo nga ang aming nga ken agapo ken mi apo Dios. Biag ayat kapiag pamilya panagserbi Kubwayan na maangit na gito'y ket nagtawag iti ayat ni Apo Diyos katatay. So in our hearts, deep in our hearts, is filled with gratefulness and we acknowledge, O God, without you, we are nothing. Nasa Diyos ang awa, nasa tao ang gawa. So to the elected leaders, your prayers have been answered and God has blessed your efforts. And this day, we tell to the world, first and foremost, we thank ni Apo Kabunyan, the maker of us all, and will grant the blessing to be elected into the office. And this was clearly shown in the first reading from the book of Kings, when the prophet Elijah was looking for a successor and he found Elisha and anointed him to be his successor as a prophet for Israel. Just to acknowledge, the authority comes from God and being transferred to us, leaders of the place of our province. So, the first reading, by the act of Elijah anointing his successor, is an acknowledgement that as we gather this morning, we once more beg God to bless all our elected officials, especially Governor Takip, Vice Governor Madam Rosario, and all the Sangguniang Panlalawigan members. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus, for giving us our new leaders.